My name is Liz Smith, and I'm Program Director for Civil Engineering. And I'm here today to tell you about all areas of engineering here at UniSA. There'll be plenty of time for questions at the end of the presentation, so please hold on to them until then. How many of you were in the Pathways presentation that was just running? Yeah, a few of you. Sorry, I'm going to repeat just a little bit of information on the couple of slides that I show. I'd like to start off by asking you all a question. What do engineers do? Does anybody want to volunteer an answer? Think about the moment that you woke up this morning. What's the first thing that you did? You might have gone and used the kitchen, turn on the kettle. Who provided the electricity for that kettle? Engineers did. They designed the distribution network for our power. What about the actual kettle itself and the car that you perhaps drove here or the mobile phone that you used? Engineers designed those also and designed and maintained the manufacturing processes to produce them. And engineers are also involved in transportation networks, so public transport networks, water supply systems and water treatment systems. So engineers are pretty much involved in every aspect of modern life at some point in regards to designing, managing, maintaining and improving systems that we use. So really engineering is about solving problems to improve your everyday. So why study engineering? Well, engineering is in high demand. There's very good employment rates and an excellent starter salary that's only second to dentistry and medicine. Why study engineering at UniSA? Well, the university highly values engineering. And they've invested a lot of money in recent years in new facilities to support research and teaching. Not that our existing facilities weren't any good, they were fantastic, but these new facilities certainly complement those. We use a lot of experiential learning at UniSA, so this is through industry experience or engaging with industry and also using a lot of project-based learning. So yes, it's important that engineers learn the theory and the fundamentals of science and maths, but it's also very important that they know how to apply this knowledge and use it to solve problems. As I said, use a lot of industry-based projects. We have guest presenters from industry, and quite a few of our tutors are practicing engineers or retired engineers. Engineering is taught at our Mawson Lakes campus, which is very accessible from Adelaide. It's about a 15-minute train ride. I catch the train from Blackwood to Mawson Lakes. It's very accessible. Of course, you can drive if you wish, and there's plenty of parking, much more parking than it's available at our city campuses. We've got strong links with industry. So as I said, we use a lot of industry-based projects, and we've got links to Technology Park, which is right next door to us. Each of our engineering programs has strong links to the research institutes or centre that's applicable to that degree. And we have several different pathways to enter into our engineering program, and I'll discuss that a bit more in a moment. We also provide an accelerated study option. So that's where rather than take 4 years to do your degree, you can do it in 3 years. So at the end of first year, those students who have performed really well, got a distinction average, are invited to join our accelerated program. And they're able to complete their degree in an additional 2 years. So you complete the degree in 3 years rather than four. There's also an option to do a master's with many of our engineering degrees. So you do your degree in 4 years, and then with an additional 1 year, you also get a master's. All our programs that we deliver here at Mawson, at UniSA, are designed to develop graduate qualities of the university. And the qualities that our engineering students develop are things like being able to be creative, inquisitive, analytical, so they're able to analyse and solve problems. They're detailed orientated. They're able to work well in teams and autonomously. Engineering as a profession is very team orientated. You have to be able to work with other professionals and other engineers, and typically you are working in multidisciplinary teams. Engineers also need to be good communicators. So 80% of the time of an engineer's time is spent communicating. So you have to be good at it. You have to be able to write reports. You have to be able to speak to people and communicate about your designs. So you're communicating with other engineers, other professionals, members of the community, and clients, and so on. And we also endeavour to ensure our students are industry ready. So they're ready to start as professionals straight away after graduation. The four principal areas that we offer at UniSA in engineering are civil engineering, electrical and electronic engineering, mechanical and manufacturing, and also mechatronic engineering. And within each of these broad areas, we also offer specialisations. All areas, or all of the major areas, have a master's option. So that's a 5-year, you do a 4-year degree and then 1 year additional to get your master's. And our degrees are accredited by Engineers Australia and they're recognised internationally through the Washington Accord. So like all engineering programs delivered in Australia, they're accredited with Engineers Australia. So it means that you can practice as an engineer anywhere in the world and you don't need to do an extra exam or test to prove your qualification. We also offer some of our engineering programs at our Whyalla campus, and that includes metallurgy, mechanical, and also our associate degree. And there are grants available for students who study at our Whyalla campus. The associate degree is also offered online, so if you're working full-time, this might be an option for you. Studying online isn't easy, but if you're motivated, you'll certainly be very successful. There are several different pathways to enter into our engineering programs, but obviously the easiest one there is to come straight from high school, from year 12, so you've done the required prerequisite, which is math studies, and you've got the required ATAR score. So the guaranteed entry ATAR score for engineering is 80. So if you get 80, you have engineering as your first preference, you get in. If you don't get the required ATAR score, but you do get you have done math studies, then you can get into our engineering program by sitting the STAT test. So that's another option. You can also do our foundation studies. That's where you've already done year 11, maybe you're returning to study after working for a while, and the foundation studies is really kind of like a year 12 and it's preparing you for the engineering program. The most common entry pathway, other than Year 12, is via the associate degree. The associate degree is basically the first year and a half of our engineering program, but it also includes half a year of maths and science fundamentals, just to prepare you to be able to do the engineering program itself. So if you do the associate degree, what will happen is that you can basically, after your first year of the associate degree, you can transfer into one of the engineering programs, or you can complete the associate degree and then apply through SATAC to enter into one of our engineering programs. So that's the ways that you can enter the associate degree are that you can come based on your Year 12 score and you apply directly to the university. The other option there is to sit the ATN test. So if you're returning to study and you've been working out in the profession, then you can sit this test. It's basically a logic test to see how well you'll cope with engineering. But typically we find that people that work in the field do really well in that test. And so, you can either come in via your Year 12 or via the ATN test. Another option there is to enter via SABET, South Australian Institute of Technology, and do a Diploma of Technology with them first. So typically students who didn't do the required prerequisites or they did do some maths but they didn't get the required ATAR, they can do the first year at SABET and then you'll enter into the second year of our engineering program. But you are required to get a specific GPA in your SABET program. Another option is if you've done some prior learning before, so maybe you've been to TAFE and you've got a diploma or an advanced diploma, then you can possibly get credit for some of those courses, and you'll need to talk to one of the program directors to discuss what courses you would get credit for. So as you can see, many different pathways into the engineering program, and it's never too late to study engineering. We've got a lot of mature age students doing really well, and some of those are working full-time and part-time and also studying. In our first year of the engineering program, we've got several courses that are common between the different disciplines. After first year, it is possible to transfer, so from mechanical into civil, for example. You can also transfer after your first year, but it's a little bit more difficult. Just to give you an idea of how we structure our classes, each of the courses typically has a lecture where all students attend, and for first year students that's around 180 to 200 students. We then have smaller tutorial classes of around 25 to 30, and we also have practical classes too in some courses that are typically have smaller class sizes than that. In second, third and fourth year, that's where you split up into your different streams, and there will be about 60 to 80 students in each of those streams at each year level. So the prerequisites to enter into our engineering program, there's just one, and that's math studies. So you must have done math studies in year 12 to enter into our program and get the right ATAR. We do have physics as assumed knowledge. Now, physics is not a prerequisite simply because not all schools offer physics, especially country schools where it's not offered or perhaps it's offered via correspondence. So we do not make physics a prerequisite. However, it is assumed knowledge. So if you've not done physics, don't worry. All you need to do is do a course in first semester, which is called Introduction to Physics, and that's also delivered in the associate degree. Then in second semester, you'll do the maths course that you didn't do in the first semester, and then that maths course that you do in the second semester is moved to the following summer. So by the time you're ready to start year 12, you've already caught up with everybody else, so it's certainly not going to put you behind. As I said before, the guaranteed entry ATAR for engineering is 80. And if you don't get 80, then don't worry, you might get enough to get the ATAR cutoff score, which is specific for each of the streams, and you can see those in the engineering brochure, so remember to grab one of those from us. Now, when you're doing your SADAC preferences and you're sure that you want to study engineering, then civil engineering, for example, put the stream that you're most interested in as number one. So, for example, civil and structural, which has a higher ATAR than the general civil stream. So you can put general civil after that, okay? So if you're sure you want to do civil engineering, just put the different streams and just list them in order of their ATAR score. So just moving on to the on-campus experience and what we offer in engineering. This is a picture of our Experience One studio. It's a state-of-the-art common first-year learning space. So it's not a teaching space, it's student-owned. And this is to support your learning. We've got sort of a large area with movable tables that's fantastic for collaborative learning and working on team projects. And we've got smaller breakout spaces that, you know, are for quiet and more individual study. The space has an outdoor area, it's got some nice comfy furniture so you can relax, and a kitchen. So it's very much the first year student's home away from home. In second and third year, we've got discipline-specific project spaces for you to use. And in final year, we've got a new fantastic space that all the engineering students get access to. So I'll just briefly go through some of the areas of engineering that we offer. And the first one there is electrical and electronic engineering. So what do electrical engineers do? Well, they design sophisticated devices and equipment and power distribution systems. And like all engineering courses that we offer, we make sure that the students are, you know, ready to enter industry, and it's all about providing society with economic and social benefits. The ATAR, or the median ATAR to enter into electrical engineering, was 75.9, and again, it's a little bit less or a little bit more for each of the streams, so check out the ATAR in the brochure. So that's the 2013 ATAR cutoff. We don't know what it's going to be for 2014, but I guess we can assume it's around the same amount. The streams that you can choose to specialise in electrical engineering is mechatronics, systems engineering, computer systems, communications and renewable energy systems. And you don't have to choose your stream right from first year. You know, you can wait until, in electrical mechanical, you can wait until your third year, and in civil engineering, you can wait until your final year. So we have students coming in wanting to do one stream, and then after first year, they're transferring into something else, and then, you know, they hear a lecture or, you know, they go on a site visit or do a project, and finally, you know, they find their passion and it's in a completely different area. So, you know, there is some flexibility to move around streams. The types of places that mechatronic engineers work, they'll work in mining, automotive, defence and manufacturing. The types of devices they might design include anti-lock brakes, artificial hearts, autofocus cameras, DVD players, robotics and so on. And like all other engineering disciplines, electrical and mechatronic can work in large, medium, small enterprises, private or government sector, consulting firms, and many of our graduates actually find work before the end of their final year. So what about civil engineering? Well, civil engineers work on design, maintenance and improvement of infrastructure such as bridges, water treatment systems, network systems, and lots of basically anything huge has had a civil engineer involved somewhere along the line. With civil engineering, we also offer a double degree with law, which takes 7 years to complete. And civil engineering is the only degree that offers a double degree. Mechanical and electrical don't have a double degree option. And our civil engineering program was actually ranked first in Australia in 2012 for the Graduate Course Experience Questionnaire, so we're very proud of that. The ATAR score, the medium ATAR score for civil streams is 73.3. Again, it's different for each of the streams, either slightly lower or slightly higher. The streams that you can choose from are the general civil stream. You can specialise in structural, environmental management, project management or transport. And again, with civil engineering, you don't have to make that decision until your final year. Civil engineers work in private industry as consulting engineers, they work in construction companies, they work in mining. Several of our ex-students work in government and semi-government departments such as DIPTI and SA Water, and also in local councils. So what about mechanical engineering? Mechanical engineers apply the principles of physics and material science for the analysis, design, manufacturing and maintenance of mechanical systems such as engines and turbines, pumps and fans, air conditioning systems and manufacturing processes and so on. The ATAR score there is 78.65, so that's a medium score for the mechanical streams. From what I understand, they no longer offer the double degree with management and information technology, but of course you can double check that with the engineering booth. So what can you specialise in regards to mechanical engineering? You can specialise in sustainable systems, mechatronic engineering, systems engineering and advanced manufacturing. And mechanical engineers typically work similar to electrical engineers in automotive, mining, defence or government. And again, like all of our graduates, as I said, they typically find work before the end of their final year. So I'll just briefly mention about some scholarships that we offer. More information is included in the brochure, and you can also just search for engineering scholarships via our website and you'll get a whole heap of information. But a couple of the ones that we've got for entering students are those who get a fantastic ATAR, and I think it's 97, I think it was, yeah, 97. And so you're coming straight from Year 12, or maybe you've got a 97 and you've been working in industry for a bit, or maybe you've taken a gap year. You're all eligible for this High Achiever Scholarship, and it's automatically awarded to those students who meet that criteria. There's also a High Achiever Equity Scholarship, so there's three of those scholarships available, and they're for school leavers from specific areas. So, well, that's all from me. Thank you.